Yo, what is up, gamers and lesbians? Sorry, not lesbians, only gamers. So, this is me, Lantima69. So, I'm gonna be like showing you my Destiny top 5 weapons. Well, only primary weapons, not like special or heavy, not that kind of some sort. So, well, I'm gonna start off with not with my Touch of Malice. I will be showing in that order. Well, before recording the video, I was just like having some fun in the dreadnought. I was jumping here and there. So, well, let's talk about the special weapons right now. So, for the special weapons, I don't actually use special weapons. I am a shotgunner like fan. I actually do not use snipers. Not that like a 360 sniper or quick shot or hard scope, not that like shit. Starting off with the number 5, let's see. Oh yeah, NL Shadow. No wait, oh yeah, we got Hawksaw. Yeah, well guys, Hawksaw, yeah, well, it's my go-go weapon. Like, this was my first Kingsfall weapon. Like, when I did raid for the first time, I used this weapon, and well, I gotta say, when I'm not that of a Crucible fan either. Well, I'm just a PvE fighter like that sort. So yeah, I heard people like saying that Hawksaw is really good in PvP, and judging by the fire rate and the reload speed, I think it's a beast in PvP, from my opinion. Not that like from the bad juju or whatever. I think it's really fast in terms of fire rate and shooting and reload speed. I think it's pretty good. And well, I think Hawksaw is pretty good. And if people judge by the fact that bad juju is good or bad, I think both are pretty good. And I think bad juju will win, in my opinion. So going at number 4, we got bad juju. Don't be like the viewers who are watching, don't be like that, guys. All right, so bad juju. Well, I said it's my opinion, so I guess it's your own guys' opinion. So bad juju. All the people, all my friends say that bad juju is a beast against Hawksaw, but let's see. I never seen a guy like Hawksaw versus bad juju. I mean, I will like check that video out on YouTube if I ever seen one like Hawksaw versus bad juju. So I think it's a pretty good gun. So sorry about that late discussion. And here we go at number 3, we got Zalo Supercell. I actually got this gun from doing the sister's secret chest. I also got a Suros Regimi, but I don't like that gun, so I switched it over to my Hunter. So guys, Zalo Supercell, I think it's pretty good, and by the classical shape and things like that, I really like it. I mean, its shape is pretty good and that thing, yeah. And I think it's pretty good in PvE, because in PvP it's a real bad gun. So at number 2, we got Touch of Malice, and I think this is a bad choice, because I think it should be at number 1, I think. But nah, it's my own opinion, and I know how to use my gun. So Touch of Malice, guys, if you we can like see the first part of the Touch of Malice. Final round of the magazine regenerates and deals bonus damage at the cost of the wielder's life force. So not a bad gun. So when I got the Touch of Malice, I didn't know how to use this gun, because look, it drains my health and I need to get that second perk so I can be an expert at this gun. Maybe check that out. But overall, Touch of Malice is nice gun. It's a beast against Oryx in Kingsfall. So at number 1, we got my favorite gun and my most used gun, the Smite of Marain. It's the raid pulse rifle, and I know it's pretty good. So as we see, like, it's 310, and I really like it. And before I did the King's Fall, I wished I had it, and I didn't wish I like could get the auto rifle, the hand cannon or whatever. I actually like wished I had it, so I got it, and I was pretty happy I got it. So yeah, I wish whenever I'll do the hard mode King's Fall, I hope so I'll get the Harold Smite of Merit, so I can like, yeah, so I can get its next 2.0 kind of thing. So yeah, its perks are really good, everything, danger cup close. So yeah, I think it covers it up. We got Zalo, Touch of Malik's Hawksaw, and Bad Juju, and Smite of Meereen. So guys, I'm gonna be ending this video right here, right now. I'll see you guys later. Lion Tamer 69 out. Peace.